Welcome to another Quilt Talk Tuesday. My name is Tina Dillard with Quilting Affection Designs. Let's see, why is my... There we go. I hope everybody can hear me. Okay. So again, my name is Tina Dillard with Quilting Affection Designs. I'm just making sure everything is working on your end so you can see me. I hope you all had a wonderful week last week and a great weekend. The weather here was gorgeous on Saturday. It was 80 some degrees. We were wearing shorts because it was so warm. And then Sunday, it got cold again. I mean cold. We got down in the 60s, but we're not getting the snow and everything. Then we had thunderstorms on Monday, early Monday morning. My husband had to go to work. So it's been, spring has really sprung here. Also last week, I got some exciting news. I received a nice little email, but if you've been watching my Quilt Talk Tuesdays on a regular basis, you know I talk about Deb Tucker Studio 180 Designs a lot. Well, I applied for their certification training, and I got the email last week. I was selected for the 2018 class, which will be held in Dallas, Texas. The end of July. I'm so excited. I got the email last week, the end of last week, and I'm still on high, and my husband is so excited for me also. So I'm really looking forward to this training. It's going to be some real tough training, but I know Deb Tucker, she'll get everything in for us and get us all ready to serve her well as a certified instructor. If you haven't tried a Studio 180 Design ruler, I really suggest you try one. And if you like that, try it, or even go to a quilt show that has demoing one. Watch how they use the rulers. They're wonderful. They're made for left or right-handed people, and they will make your blocks, your quilt blocks, look really, really sharp and ready to go to put in your quilt. So I really suggest you try one out. Let's see. Also, I've been collaborating on a April Mysteries quilt with Carrie Schell. Her net business is called the On Point Quilter. She specializes in teaching quilters electronic quilt, which is called EQ8, and it's she makes it very easy peasy way of doing it through online instruction. She is really good at it, and the classes are well worth it. For the last couple of weeks, we've been doing it in April showers. Every Saturday the blog post will come out. And what she does is she shows you on her end how to do it in the EQ, how to design the block and put it and make it in there. Then I, on my side, show how to piece the instructions through the Studio 180 Design blocks, ruler tools. The tools that we've been using are the corner beam and the squared rulers. And it's been a fun collaboration on going back and forth. So if you're interested in something like that, make sure you check out my blog. The blog post is listed in the description area along with the description of this post. We're starting this next week, week three, but on this Saturday. So if you haven't joined in, you could still be able to do it whenever you feel like it. I'm gonna keep the videos out. I should say I also do videos with my piecing instructions for this blog. So that helps you out also. But I'm going to keep the pattern remaining on my site. So make sure you go to the blog part or the link to the area on the blog post. It'll take you straight into the first video this first week, and you can download all the pattern and you can watch the videos there also. There's links to the videos. So make sure you check that out. And I also want to remind you, if you're interested in my Rambling Star Block of the Month, it's going to start going on sale May 1st. I'm providing a lot of help for this project. I have a Facebook group. We are doing a quilt along starting June 1st. We're going to be doing that. And I have step-by-step videos each month to show you how to make the blocks and put them together using the Studio 180 Design rulers. So if you like more information, please visit my website or join the Facebook group. Again, the link description is in there. So make sure you watch that and join our group if you're interested. Also, if you feel free to, as we continue on this show, leave your comments, questions, please post them in the comment section. Feel free to post them. Even share with others if you like to. I saw someone was sharing, I think. And I really appreciate you sharing out there and helping others that would like to learn. So let's get started with this week. This week we are continuing our Quilting Basics 101 series. We're going to talk about seam allowances. And seam allowances need to be very precise to help get you an enjoyable quilt. Having an accurate, reliable 1/4 inch seam allowance is the first step in enjoyable quilting. With this, you'll find blocks will fit together easily and finish square and lay flat. Today, I'm going to show you some tools that will help you find your 1/4 inch seam allowance. And also, we're going to do an accuracy. I'm going to show you how to do an accuracy test on your pattern, with some fabric, and that'll show if your 1/4 inch is accurate or not. So, to start out with, there are several ways to get your seam allowance and keep it. You can use 1/4 inch seam, 1/4 inch feet for your machine if it comes with one. You can also buy feet for your machine if it doesn't come with them also. This one's off my Bernina. I just took it off and it has a good 1/4 inch area for it also already. Now, this one's off my Janome, and it has a straight edge next to it. So this is the 1/4 inch foot also. It's called the edge foot. A lot of people like to use this one. I use it for my Janome because that's the only one I have for the 1/4 inch for that one, which is the machine's behind me. I'm using it right now for machine quilting. Those are two different types of feet to do it. Now for guides, you can also use tape for guides when you find your machine. Another way to help find it is using your ruler. I'm going to show you in a minute how to use your ruler to find your 1/4 inch seam allowance. There's also gauges that'll help you. You can find these on different places like Amazon and different ones. This one has the eighth, the scant, and the quarter an inch lines in it. And you can see it right here. It's called the ideal seam gauge. And I want to remind you also that I'm just pointing some things out. I'm not affiliated with any of these products seen on any of my shows. Also, this one here also does the same thing. It has the quarter an inch. I don't know if you can see that. It's probably blurry. But it has a quarter an inch, 3/8, a half, 5/8, and 3/4 on it already. So that's those are two other ways. You got masking tape when you find your seam allowance. There's also Diz has one that's has three adhesive guides in it, and it also talks you how to find your seam allowance on the back of the thing. These are just padded pieces, and you can cut them to size, and they will tape on the back. Will be taped to your machine. The one I have on my machine, you can see here, is from Quilt with Marcy Baker. They're little pieces of tape, and they'll help you guide through your make a guide for your machine also. Let's see, you can use moleskin even if you wanted to when you mark it, or post-it notes. If you have a way to do it, post it and share on the comment section. There's other ways I've seen lately, people using from the hardware store, you can get lasers and put on your machine and point it down also to mark where your guide for that. I haven't tried that yet. I've seen it. I've just haven't been to the hardware store lately to do that. Let's see. Let's go ahead and show you how to find your quarter of an inch seam allowance using your ruler. Now, your normal ruler will have a guide area of a quarter of an inch. So, and you can see it on my ruler here. So let's, I'm gonna take this to my machine, and I know you're not gonna be able to see exactly what I'm doing, but I'm gonna pull my threads out of the way. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take and gently, with them a hand crank, let's lay my needle down on that quarter of an inch line, just to the right of it, to get a quarter of an inch line. And I dropped it down, it's touching it. And you gotta be careful, because you don't wanna break your needle. And I put my foot down just to help it. Now you wanna make sure your ruler is straight and lined up. Because you want to make sure when you put your tape down or your some kind of adhesive next to it, that you get everything lined up and straight, so you have a guideline that's straight as you do your stuff go through. So now we're going to go ahead, and I'm going to go ahead and use a piece of blue tape. You can use frog tape. This is a little wider than I wanted. Now, you don't want to put this on where your feed dogs are going to work through. So be careful of that. Now, I already have that piece of edging from this sew edge already down, so I'm gonna just put this over it for now to give you an idea. But you'll just put it right next to it and lay it down and lay it flat. So now I'll take my hand crank, bring my needle back up, bring my presser feed up, and I should have a nice accurate quarter of an inch. Or this one, the way I've kind of set it up is for a scant. because you really want a scant because of the fact when you sew your pieces together, you're going to get a little bit of edge and you're going to lose some fabric. So we're going to use that for that section. So that is a way to find your quarter of an inch. Now you can also use these gauges. They work the same way. You put your gauge underneath your foot and your needle, and you bring your needle down. And I go ahead, bring your foot down again, and you have your quarter of an inch line, and you can lay your tape next to it, in front of it, and do the same thing. It works the same way with all of these gauges. So now to check your accuracy and making sure that you do have your quarter of an inch, I suggest this little test. And I've seen this several times on the internet that they use the same way. So what we're gonna do is you're gonna take and cut two pieces of 1.5 by 4 inch pieces of fabric, and you're gonna have those the same color, and then you're gonna cut one that's the opposite color or a different color even, and that's gonna be the same size, 1.5 by 4 inches. What you're going to do is you're going to go ahead and you're gonna sew two strips together along that 4 inch line, making sure everything is lined up, and you're going to sew. Put your foot down and you're going to begin sewing, making sure your edges are lined up, and follow that line up. Now you want to make sure you're doing it slow, and so you do get an accurate seam allowance. And I would recommend that on all your projects. This is not a race. We want nice quality blocks done. So take your time on sewing. So when you're done, take your out of your machine, and we're going to go ahead. I'm going to cut that thread out of our way. And we're going to go on the other side of that mid-center piece that we want, and we're going to add our other quarter of an inch, our 1.5 inch strip. And we're going to place that down, and we're going to sew that on the opposite side. So again, making sure you have everything lined up and you're doing a nice quarter of an inch seam allowance. Now, another reason we'll do this is because we want to check off the fabric. Our fabric, like a flannel, or something that you would use that's thicker, it's going to have a different seam allowance. So you may want to adjust for that with that seam allowance. This is definitely a way to check with your fabrics, because each fabric is going to be a little heavier or thicker to do that. So now we've got that sewn. We're going to go set our seams with our iron, and we're gonna press towards the outside. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm gonna flip this around. I'm sorry for moving this, but limited cameras. So you can see what I'm doing. I have my iron here. And I'm gonna press it open. And I'm gonna do the same thing on the opposite side. Press that seam and press open. I moved my my ironing board over so we can actually have an iron today. So now we have it all pressed. We're gonna take our ruler and we're gonna place that on top of our piece. Your piece should measure 4 by 3.5. And mine does 4 and 3.5. Your each section, your two outer sections should be 1 1/4 on both sides and 1 inch in the middle. Now, if you need to adjust anyway, you should be able to move your needle. If you have an older machine, you should be able to do it also, but check your machine. Or you're gonna have to move your tape over also if you can't move your needle. So like on this piece here, I had to adjust with my needle a one notch over to make sure I was correct. So if it's too small, if it's too wide, you wanna go smaller, you wanna increase it. If it's too large, you want to reduce it. So you're gonna have to play with your needle just a little bit to find your accurate seam allowance. Once you do have that accurate seam allowance, make sure you put your tape down or something to help you guide you through that area. Think that is pretty much it. So play with your seam allowances. Once you find that little sweet happy spot, make note of it. Do something to help you remember where that sweet spot is on your machine. I have the memory. I put it in there and it stays there. It helps, and I can just hit that button and it'll go straight over to it. So in your machine, you may want to mark a little notch or something with your knobs or controls for the older machines. So when you find that little sweet spot, keep it, and it's going to make you so much happier with the end result of having a accurate seam allowance on your blocks. You're going to find your blocks are going to come out much nicer and accurate when you have it all nice and pressed open. Okay, let me check to see if we have any comments. Don't see anything. So today we've discussed how to do the seam allowance. So next week we're going to continue with our Quilting 101 series. I'm going to walk you through how to read a quilt pattern. A lot of people struggle with it. So I'm going to take you through one of my beginning patterns and walk you through how to read a piecing pattern. So we're going to be doing that next week. So that is it for this week. Be sure to sign up for my newsletter, my blog. If you're watching this from another group or something, please remember to like my page, like my quilting page. I appreciate that. I see a Karen is on there. I want to say hi to her. Thank you for commenting. So I think that is it this week. So remember to check out my April mystery quilt with Carrie Shell, the On Point Quilter. Also make sure you check out my Rambling Star. So that's it, and I want to thank you for joining me, and feel free to share these videos with your friends and family. And thank you for all the likes. I really appreciate it. And have a great week. And I will see you next Tuesday at 2:30 p.m. Eastern Time for Quilt Talk Tuesday. Bye, everyone.